Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. So they say the subsequent fall was inevitable. They never stood a chance, it was written that way. Innocent victims of their story.
Hello, we are EMT 100.
And we will be performing Matilda,
written by Dennis Kelly. Matilda, what a pleasure to see you here in the library again, are we?
Oh, yes. Mom and Dad told me to scram. They don't like it when I'm around too often.
You know, I lost my parents in a terrible accident when I was a young girl like you.
Really?
Yes. I was placed in care of my father's evil sister. She was nothing but cruel to me, and still is.
Well, I guess we both have something in common. But I think I can do more than you can.
Oh?
I can move things with my mind.
Can you now?
But you can't tell anyone. It's a secret. I'm sorry to leave you now. It's lunchtime. I can't miss it. We're having roast beef and Yorkshire pudding.
Knock on the door, Jenny. Just knock on the door. Nothing to fear, don't be pathetic. It's just a door, you've seen one before. Just a knock on the door. Look at you trying to hide and silly, standing outside the principal's office like a little girl. It's just pathetic.
Ugh.
Motto, Miss Honey?
Bombinatum est magitum.
Bombinatum est magitum. Children are maggots! In fact, it was probably her who put that stink bomb under my desk this morning. I'll have her for that. Thank you for suggesting it.
Miss Trunchbull, Matilda Wormwood is a genius.
Nonsense, haven't I just told you she's a gangster?
She knows.
So she's learned a few tricks.
But she can read.
So can I.
In my opinion, this little girl should be placed in the top form with the 11-year-olds.
What? But she's a squid, a shrimp, an unhatched tadpole. We cannot just place her in the top form with the 11-year-olds. What kind of society would that be? What about rules, honey? Rules?
I believe that Matilda Wormwood is an exception to the rules.
An exception to the rules? In my school, look at these trophies, see how my trophies gleam in the sunlight, see how they shine. What do you think it took to become English hammer throwing champion? 1969, do you think in that moment, when my big moment came, that I treated the rules with casual disdain? Well, like hell! As I stepped up to the circle, did I change my plan? What? As I talked up my palms, did I wave my hand? I did not. As I started my spin, did I look at the view? Did I drift off in dream for a minute or two? Do you think I altered my intended elevation? Do you think I altered my intended elevation? As the hammer took off, did I change my grunt from the grunt I had practiced for many a month? Not a jot, not a dot, did I stray from the plot? Not a detail of my throw was adjusted or forgotten. Not even when the hammer left my hand and sailed high up, up above the stands. Did I let myself go? If you want to throw the hammer for your country, you have to stay inside the circle all the time. Dun, dun, dun. We don't need happiness or self-esteem. You just need to keep your feet inside the line. Sing, Jenny. 2, 3, 4.
If you want to throw the hammer for your country,
you're off? You have to stay inside the circle all the time. And if you want to teach success, you don't use sympathy or tenderness. You have to force the little squids to toe the line. Lara Jenny, 2, 3, 4. I just one simple rule to have a thrilling life and school. I've also learned to throw it, find the woolly line and tow it, and always keep your feet inside the line. Now get out. And it won't be long before I smell the palm of aiding and abetting. A bit of phys ed will tell us who has a head full of rebellious thoughts. Just like a rotten egg floats to the top of a bucket of water, the smell of rebellion.
Look, the chalk! The chalk, it's moving!
What?
It's moving.
Writing something.
Agatha.
This is Magnus.
No, he can't.
Give my Jenny back her house, then leave. Or I will get you like you got me.
Run! 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 Run!
Mysteriously turned up, and she was now the owner of a beautiful old house, which then had been owned up by one evil aunt, Miss Agatha Trunchbull. Her and Matilda moved in immediately, and they were very happy,
happier than they'd ever been in their entire lives.
And as for Miss Trunchbull, she was never seen again, and a new headmistress took over.
And her name was Miss Honey, and it was said to be the best school in all the land.
Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay, and that's not right.
And if it's not right, you have to put it right. But nobody else is gonna put it right for me. Nobody but me is gonna change my story.
Sometimes you have to be a little bit naughty.
Maggots.